Dawson and I'm the winner of the RSV's Nancy Rothwell Award for the 15 to 18 year old category for my specimen drawing of the broad-snouted caiman. Receiving the award, I must say, was quite surprising. Looking back at the previous winner's pieces was really humbling, and I just feel blessed that the judges thought that my piece was of a similar standard. My inspiration actually came from a book my dad bought me on physiology and anatomy. As I was flicking through the pages, there was one drawing that really stood out to me, and it was of a crocodile skull. It never really occurred to me how complex the reptilian skull actually was. My biggest inspiration is probably my great-grandfather. He was an amazing draftsman, and looking back at his portraits and, you know, even his rough sketches puts his talent into perspective. Just trying to follow in his footsteps and trying to emulate his artistic ability is what really keeps me going. The main thing I enjoy about drawing is being able to translate the ideas I have in my head into a tangible illustration that anyone can appreciate. And the other thing I really enjoy is that in art, there are no rules or structures that you need to follow. Everything an artist does is everything they want to do. And I think that's quite freeing in a way.
Hello, my name is Professor Susan Standring, and I'm one of the judges for the RSB's Nancy Rothwell Award. Now, I've been judging these paintings and pictures for the last 7 years, and I never cease to be amazed and delighted by the quality of your entries. The judges, of course, look for scientific zoological accuracy. They look for the way in which you have placed the material on the page and what you have chosen to show. Sometimes you've copied a photograph, sometimes you've brought together information from diverse sources and married them so beautifully. It was very clear when I looked at the shortlist, there was one that shone out very clearly. It had a wow factor, and that is the broad-nosed caiman from Shivani Dawson. And when I look at that caiman, you can see him in the mangrove swamp, just with his snout sticking up above the water, snout and eyes. And it's a very clever picture, and Shivani has taken her source from different sources. She's used photographs for the external part above the water, and she's gone to a dissector to look at the underneath, which is the bones and the teeth, which is what you would meet if you happen to be the unfortunate prey of this caiman. And she's done it beautifully. The colour palette is very sympathetic. It's very dark above and it's bright white below. And you're very aware of the water, and you're passing between the air and down below the water to see the skeleton. But it's also aesthetically, it's one of those things that just stops you in your tracks and say, wow, that is extraordinary. So very many congratulations to everybody, but particularly to Shivani for producing a beautiful piece of work. Thank you.